Morning, children. How are you all? Okay, now today we begin with our revision work, and all of you take out your general science reader and plants in the surroundings, lesson number 5. Yes, come. Now in this you will be learning all this: what is creeper, what is tree, what is herb and shrubs. Shrubs, climbers, all the name you have to learn it, okay? So you learn this part of a plants and their function. You learn structure of a seed, germination of a seed. And in this parts of a plant here, you see, draw this in your rough notebook. What will you do? You will draw this in your rough notebook. And you will label them, yes? And you will learn about it. Here this is the shoot system and this is the root system. So see that you learn their function also. Now here see root. What is the root you should know? They have got tap root, fibrous root. Yes, and this is the function of the root. So this here also you will have to learn. All you have to learn. This you will be drawing in your rough notebook and you will label it. Yes, this you will learn the names. Okay, now turn to page number 52. Stem, what is a stem? That also you will learn. Now you learn the function of the stem also. Learn this also. Yes, you learn this. What is the stem you learn? It's all one line answer and function of the stem. Then come to the revision zone. Give two examples for each of the following. Plants with tap roots, carrot and radish. Plants with fibrous root, grass, rice, wheat, onion. Stems that store food, ginger, potato and sugarcane. Learn all this. Learn this and complete this blanks, okay? Now you learn about the leaf also. You will draw this in your rough notebook. Yes, in the rough notebook you will draw it, you will label it, you will learn all this. This all you will learn about the leaf, about the name that a leaf is called, the leaf blade or the lamina. All these names are here. See, leaf stalk or the petiola. And the thin tube running down the center is called main vein. Tubes coming out of the side of the main vein are called the side veins. So you will learn all this parts of the leaf. Then you will learn what is a stomata. Learn what is a chlorophyll. Then you learn about the function of the leaves. Okay, all this you will learn. Now you turn to next page and you will learn about the function of the flowers. Flowers are very useful. They look beautiful and they attract insects. Why they attract insects? And it sucks, the insects sucks nectar from the flowers. Yes, so you will be learning about this. And then you will learn about the seeds also. Learn about the seeds. Then the kind of seeds. You learn about all this. See, this I had explained you. So learn, only learn. You should know what is it. No need to draw, you will be learning. Learn all these names. These are called seed leaves or the cotyledon, dicotyledon, monocotyledon, all the names you should know. Then you learn about the germination. You learn about this also, germination. What is germination? How it is done? This you will draw in your rough notebook. This also you will draw in your rough notebook and learn it. Now turn to, and here also the keywords. You will write this in your rough notebook and you will learn it. This also you will learn because in this some answers are there, okay? Now turn to the page number 58. Here we will do, here this also you will write in your rough notebook. Yes, this is your revision work, okay? Now see, choose correct answer for each of the following. Which of these plants has fibrous root? Grass. Put a tick on it. Which of these is the stem that we eat? Potato. Put a tick on it. Which of these are leaves that we eat? Cabbage. Put a tick on it. Flowers grow into which of the following? Fruits. Put a tick on it. And see that your back exercise is complete and you write this in your rough notebook. This is your revision work. Fill in the blanks. The part of a plant that grows above the soil is called shoot. Put a tick on it. The part of a plant that grows into the soil is called root. Put a tick on it. Root. Wheat has a fibrous root. Put a tick on fibrous. The green color of the leaf is due to the presence of the chlorophyll. Put a tick on chlorophyll. Photosynthesis is the process by which leaves make food for the plant. Put a tick on photosynthesis. Now, question and answer we have done in the classwork notebook. So you don't have to write it down. You have to learn it. Okay, half all the questions answer, you have to learn it thoroughly. Yes, this also you will learn it. Okay, this all both third and fourth we have written in the classwork notebook. So see that you learn it very well and label the parts of a plant in the picture given below. Now this is the diagram and you will label it, and the same you will draw in your rough notebook and you will label it. Now turn to page number 60. Here this is the steps given, stages. So number the following stages of the germination in correct order. If you know your germination part well, you will know. So first stage is the seed. Second stage, it will grow up little with roots and all. Third stage is little more, it will grow and it will be very clear. Fourth stage, little more it will grow, it will turn big and it will open from here. Fourth, this is the fifth stage. Then both the seeds are here and the leaves are here. And the sixth stage, it will bloom fully. Now here, label the parts of a leaf given below here and explain different parts of a leaf. Here, if you learn the names of the leaves, then you can explain it and you will label your diagram very well. Now this is, write the names of fruit with one seed and fruits with many seeds in the space provided below. One seed and many seeds. Now mango has got one seed, lychee has got one seed, cherry has got one seed and many seeds. Watermelon, papaya, apple, guava, orange, they have got many seeds. So you should learn all your back exercise well, your answers well. If you know your back exercise, if you know this, you are able to answer everything. Okay children, so see that you learn very well. This is your revision work and keep learning very well and see that your classwork notebook is neat and tidy, all diagrams are up to date, your index is complete. Okay children, and be prepared for any time for your test. Okay, take care and have a good day.